then. How are you doing?
All good.
I'm good. So how are you guys? I mean, this is a kind of big European tour started up. So how is the progress and everything? Give us a bit of update.
It's been great, especially since we know both bands, Amorphis and Before the Dawn, beforehand.
Yeah.
From playing gigs together in Finland and stuff. So we all know. We know that they're all cool guys. We know the crew. So it's just like one big family traveling. And the show's been great. A lot of people.
Cool.
Amorphis pulling large crowds, which is great for us to win over some new fans. So.
Wicked. And you guys are friends, isn't it? Like back in the country, you.
Yeah. Well, we know we're not like this close.
Okay.
We meet them every now and then in bars and.
Cool. Hang on. So. So last time, when were you guys here last time in UK?
2005.
Okay.
May, I think, between from.
Okay.
Same venue, Underworld. It was packed and it was cool.
Cool. Why is it been so long that, you know, you guys didn't turn up?
Tell me, I have no idea. We've done two European tours after that.
Okay.
2006, 2007, and no British dates of those.
Oh, okay.
So, I don't know.
Is it the label sort of side they're not interested, or is it the logistics and
stuff? It's the logistics all the way.
Okay.
When we go to tour or get opening slot on the tour, it's a ready package. We have no say in whatsoever. So we just get the list, like these countries, and unfortunately there were no
Just have to do it basically what they say.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh man. Okay, so you got a new album out, Show Your Colors.
Yes.
How is it different from your previous albums?
It's quite different, to say the least. The first three ones were more technical, death, thrash metal.
Okay.
With all raw vocals, which made it sound even more death metal than it actually was.
Okay.
Whereas this one with the new singer is all clean vocals, which is something we wanted to do for a long time to get out more into that area.
Okay.
And after Nico, our old singer, decided to leave, he told us that he has motivational problems, blah blah blah.
Okay.
I just told the guys, like, let's just go all the way instead of trying to do a little bit of the soil work thing to do, like,
maybe
clean choruses, like, fuck that, let's go all the way.
All the way. Just give it a try, see how it
big choruses and something totally new for us.
Cool. Now, coming back to the vocal part, So the reason you guys changed the vocalist style, is it because is the band's motivation just want to give a try with something new and stuff?
Well, no, actually we didn't even think about it before he told us that he's going to leave.
Okay.
Because he was such a big part of the band, we never thought that we're going to fire him or anything.
Okay.
If he would have stayed in the band, we just would have always done whatever he's capable of.
Okay.
Maybe a little bit clean vocals with mostly growling.
Okay.
But since he decided to leave, we might have just as well tried anything we feel like.
Okay.
And that's what we want to Show Your Colors.
Wicked. And how's the new guy settling down with the band?
Really good. We're wondering first if it's going to be a deep or something, because he sold a lot of solo albums.
We're
talking like two platinum albums worth of albums.
So he's like a professional.
He's done two albums and he has his own band also.
Okay. What's his band called?
It's his name, Ari Koivonen.
He goes
by his own name and
Okay.
But yeah, we made sure that it's not like a side project or a fun thing for him, just a little bit of a moral on the side, because this is our life work here.
Yeah.
But he's really committed and he's one of the guys now.
Cool. The sound of Amoral has been very dynamic and unique, and it's amazingly melodic as well. I mean, Finnish band, you know, what can you say? Where's the influence and stuff comes from? Like, it's quite creative stuff you guys do.
We try to use, like, mix all the good parts of metal and rock and music in no particular genre. Just take everything we like and mix it together and see if it works. And if the song works, we'll use it. Doesn't matter if it's, especially now since we can do clean vocals.
Yeah.
We can do an acoustic song and a metal song with blast beats, and then like something more in the Bon Jovi vein, you know, with a big chorus and just go crazy all over the place, which is fun. We can do whatever we want.
So what would you say the overall band influence on the bands you guys listen to?
Well, it's changed a lot over the years, and there's been more and more bands that we get into as we go along.
Okay.
It used to be when we were 14, you know, Pantera, Metallica, Sepultura, the usual big ones. Then came the death metal genre with Morbid Angel and all that stuff, where we actually learned to play some of the more fast stuff. And but it depends who you ask.
Myself,
it's always been more the 80s rock, the Guns N' Roses, the Skid Rows.
Awesome.
Whereas you ask the drummer, he will tell you that it's the Niles and the Morbid Angels. So, but that's a cool mix. Like, I'm playing a hard rock riff and he'll play a little bit more metal on it.
Yeah. And I mean, life is fun, isn't it? It's different and stuff.
It doesn't have to be like something specific.
Yeah, I'm a bit big Skid Row fan as well, so
yeah,
good to know.
Great,
tell us about the influence of the songs, and what's the story behind the lyrics? Who writes the lyrics?
Well, for this album, I wrote all the lyrics.
It used to be
me and the ex-singer together.
Okay.
Since I wrote a lot of the stuff before we even knew who's going to be the new singer, I just decided I'm going to give it a shot to do all of it, which was kind of scary at first, because I've only used to doing half of an album.
Okay.
But it ended up being quite easy. I had a lot to say.
Awesome.
Like, just for the last 2 years, it's been some bullshit and some good times, and it just came pretty naturally, so I was pretty happy to do it all by myself. But we'll see. There's no rules to who writes these songs, who writes the lyrics. If Adi comes up with a great pair of lyrics, we'll use them. And
It's a much more democratic way of sorting.
Yeah, try to keep it a band thing.
Wicked, okay, indeed. Is there will be any Amoral UK show in the future, you reckon?
Yeah, for sure, at some point, but I have no idea. Yeah, actually I only know of a couple of Finnish gigs coming up for next January.
Okay.
I have no idea what we're going to do.
After.
But we're trying to get some more shows, some more tours maybe, and start actually thinking about the next album, also writing songs all the time.
Okay. Any last words for the fans today, or whoever sees this video?
Yeah, besides the usual, check the album because it's gonna kick me like rock your world. I hope you guys are here tonight because it's packed and it's gonna be a cool 30 minutes of show. It's a short show, but we're gonna give it our best.
Cool. Thanks, man. Thanks for doing the interview, and good luck with the show today and the rest of the tour.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.